Hey everyone, welcome to another video. I have partnered with Microsoft Canada on this video to show you how you can say goodbye to local dev environments with help of GitHub Codespaces. For anyone who doesn't know what GitHub Codespaces is, this is a really good video on how to get started with it. I'm at the homepage for GitHub Codespaces. What it does is it basically creates a dev container for you in the cloud that you can utilize as your dev environment. So think about, you know, how easy it will be onboarding to a new team, the packages that are needed. You can all have that in a configuration file in your GitHub repository, and you can launch this container directly from your GitHub repository URL. I'll show you how you can do that, but you can also still use VS Code that's available locally on your machine and connect it to the remote container. So to get started, if you remember, we talked about the Python Stocks app in one of the demos earlier. So today we'll be utilizing GitHub Codespaces for this project. Kind of remember, you know, we needed Flask, we needed YFinance and other libraries and packages. So you'll see how all of those packages you can add it to a configuration file and it'll be pre-installed for your dev container. The simple way to start with GitHub Codespaces is if you go to any GitHub repository and if you click on code, the drop down, you'll see there is local and then there is Codespaces. And you can see I haven't set any Codespaces for my repository yet. So let's go ahead and create Codespace on main. And now you can see I can interact with my repository through VS Code in a browser. It just opens up so many possibilities. So let's say I'm traveling. I want to, you know, have a powerful dev environment where I can code for this project. I can do that through my notebook or laptop or even iPad because it's supported on the browser. Now I have GitHub Codespace running. So this is a container, it a random name. And then you can see it's also already in the Python stocks directory. And you can see on the right hand side where my files are. So let me zoom in a little so that it's more readable. All of the files are directly from my repository. So it basically opened up the repository in VS Code on a container. So that's how it works. And now what I wanted to show you is if I do Python dash dash version, you can see there is 3.10 already installed. Let's see if I can do a Flask run. So Flask run, and it says Flask not found, which means the Python package Flask or the library Flask is not installed by default. And that's what we are going to do with the configuration file so that you don't have to install anything when you get started with GitHub Codespaces and get started with this container. Think of ways how easy it'll be to onboard either new engineers or if you are onboarding to a new team where you have made this configuration file for the GitHub Codespace container and they just open up the repository, click on that drop down and launch the container. And all of the packages are already installed. You don't have to set them locally up, but there is still an option to use your local VS Code by connecting to the remote container. So in order to do that, what you have to do is, and all of the documentation is available from GitHub, so it's really easy to follow. But what you have to do is you have to create a new directory here called .devcontainers, and you have to create a file devcontainer.json, which you can specify how the container should be built, which Docker file should it use, and what are some packages that need to be installed. If I clone this locally, and let's add those files in, so I can stop this Codespace. And then for local, I already have this cloned. So let me open that up. So this is my local VS Code. I opened up the project called Python Stocks, and I think it's up to date, but we'll do a git pull just in case. So it's already up to date. So it's in sync with my GitHub repository. What we want to do is create a .devcontainer repository. So container, we have to specify a file which is a JSON file called devcontainer.json, and now we can specify the contents of this file. So what I'll do is I'll create a Docker file in the same directory. We'll name it Python environment since, you know, this is a Python project. So we'll save this. We'll be looking at this Docker file, so we need to create that. So let's create another file in the same directory .devcontainer called python dash environment, or short for env. The syntax is for the Docker file, right? So from Python and then 3.9, I think we used for this one for the project. We'll do copy requirements.txt, because remember we created requirements.txt, right? So this file created, this file had all the packages that are needed for Stocks app to run. And we use this in our GitHub action for the Azure web app. So these packages were needed to run our Flask app. So what we'll do is we'll create another requirements.txt in the dev container directory and include all these packages in there. Let's do that before I specify it in the Docker file. So let's create requirements. I could could have just copied and pasted it. Let's go with this. So I have a requirements.txt in dev container directory, and I'll save this. Now we can say that from Python 3.9 and then copy requirements.txt, and then also run the command to install these requirements, and also run the command. If you remember, we used pip, which is Python's package manager. Say pip install, you know, all of these requirements. And what the requirements are? These are the requirements. So what we'll do is the run pip install dash r and then requirements.txt. This is our Docker file. It is being used in devcontainer.json. And then this Docker file is using the requirements.txt to install all the packages on our container. So we are pretty good with dev container files for our GitHub Codespace container. Let's commit this added dev container files, and let's push those changes. So once they're pushed, let's go back to the Python stocks repository on GitHub and click refresh. So it says added dev container file, and let's see if I click on code spaces and let's click on create a GitHub code space. And you can also delete, so I can delete the one that is stopped right now that I created a few minutes ago so that it's cleaned up. So it just created a new one called potential doodle and it's active. It did found the image and now it's building the container. So you can see what's going on behind the scenes here. I click on view logs. So what it's doing is it's taking those configuration files that we just created in the dev container directory and building the container out, which means like Flask was not already installed previously. As we saw, it will be installed now. So you can see it's doing that, installing collected packages, it's installing YFinance, Flask, pandas. So we'll wait for that. And another way, so I showed you how you can directly create the configuration file and commit to it to your repository, but you can also click on the options and configure the dev container right from the GitHub. It'll do the same thing. It'll create the .dev container directory and then dev container.json file, and then you added it. But I just show you how you can do it. That's just another way of configuring code spaces. So we have our code spaces running. You can see I have got the dev container now, right, which we just committed, and you can already see we have the exact same files that, you know, we were expecting. So let's do Flask run now and see if it works. So you can see it started a Flask server at local port 5000. And there is another feature of GitHub Codespaces that I wanted to show. Since this is a container, you know that we cannot view the website on a local host address. So what it does is it allows you to make the local host on the container public. So you can see how I'm connected to my Flask app now. And this is the URL that it gave me for a preview. Our Flask app is running, and you can make this public so that others can also look at your local code running. So this is not deployed to anything. So not Azure, not AWS. This is not deployed to any of the cloud resources yet. This is just the dev container that's running it on its local port 5000, and it has given it a public URL that's accessible over the internet. So that is a really neat feature for GitHub Codespaces, because now you can share it with other developers. If you're debugging something and you ran into an issue, you don't have to configure port forwarding on your local machine. You can use dev containers inbuilt feature to do that. So that was how you configure GitHub Codespaces and install all the necessary packages. And for me, if something changes, right, if started updating this project and maybe I'm using other libraries, I'll just add them to requirements.txt, and that way it'll be included in my dev container. And now I wanted to show you how you can connect to this remote container from your local VS Code. So this is still in browser, right? So what I'll do is open up my VS Code locally. So this is my local VS Code installation. And if I go into the extensions, you need GitHub Codespaces, and if you click on install, it should install the extension. It's easy to connect to our remote container with the help of this extension. So if I do Control Shift P Codespaces, and it'll ask us to log in, right? Authorize Visual Studio Code, and this should open the connection to our remote container now. So if I type in Codespaces, now if I click on connect to Codespace, and you can see the potential doodle, right? It has 2 cores, 4 GB RAM, and 32 gigs of storage, which was last used 10 minutes ago, is available now to connect. And if I click on it, it'll open up a new VS Code window that's connected to my dev container. So right now, all of this, so right now, this VS Code is running on the dev container, but I can edit the code locally locally. You can also see that if I open up the terminal here, it says root at codespaces, a random number here. So I'm remotely logged in into my dev container, and that's where I am running this code on. If you do flask run here now, it should still work. So you just saw how you can configure GitHub Codespaces and also use, not only use it remotely in the browser windows, but also with your local VS Code installation. The main selling point for me is that it takes away the headache of setting up local dev environments. Oftentimes my local dev environments would break, so this takes it away because I have a specific container that has all the packages needed for a project installed already. I just hit on run GitHub Codespace container and it does it for me, and I can use it on my iPad, notebooks that are not powerful enough to run the code. I hope you liked the video, and GitHub offers resources to help devs explore and get started with GitHub Codespaces. As I showed you, there is a lot of documentation available on how to set this up. There's different type of containers and resources that are available. You can visit aka.ms/rk3 to find out detailed information from GitHub, including the guides to help you out setting up GitHub Codespaces. Peace.